فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدِ اهْتَدَوْا وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، ماذا أخذنا في الدرس الماضي؟
In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the One who bestows mercy, indeed all praise is due to Allah, and may peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First of all, what did we take in the previous lesson?
Now,
what did we study in the previous lesson?
Ashhadu la ilaha illallah wa ashiya ukhra.
Way of memorizing Quran.
So we studied how we should memorize Quran.
أخذنا أننا ندرس الدروس المهمة.
We said that we should study these important lessons.
لأنها مهمة.
Why? Because they are important.
ونصح بها العلماء.
And because the scholars have advised us with this.
وفيها أشياء تتعلق بحياة المسلم اليومية.
And because these important lessons contain matters which relate to our daily life as a Muslim.
تحتوي على طريقة السلف في حفظ ودراسة القرآن.
And it includes how the Salaf used to memorize and study the Quran.
والتوحيد وما ضد التوحيد وهو الشرك.
And التوحيد and the opposite of التوحيد which is shirk.
والصلاة.
The prayer.
وضوء والطهارة.
Purification and ablution.
تجهيز الميت تكفين والصلاة عليه.
And the preparation of the funeral.
والآداب والأخلاق الإسلامية.
And also manners and morals of Islam.
وأخذنا طريقة السلف في حفظ القرآن.
Also we spoke about the methodology of the Salaf when it comes to memorizing the Quran.
لابد أن نحفظ في كل يوم.
That we should memorize something from the Quran every single day.
وننظر في تفسير هذه الآيات من تفسير مختصر.
And also we should look into a concise explanation of the Quran.
ونستعين بالله العمل.
And also that we should seek the help of Allah in implementing the Quran.
نبدأ الآن بإذن الله تعالى بالدرس الثاني.
We're now going to begin the second lesson.
التوحيد. لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟
Why should we study Tawheed?
من يعرف؟ لو قال لنا قال لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟
If a person was to say to you, why do you study Tawheed? What should we say?
حق الله على العبيد.
Because it is the right of Allah upon the worshippers.
لا يقبل الله سبحانه وتعالى أي عمل إلا بالتوحيد.
Because Allah does not accept any act of worship without Tawheed.
لا يدخل الجنة إلا موحد.
Because the only person who will enter into paradise is a person of Tawheed.
دعوة الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام أتباع من بعدهم.
Because this is the da'wah, this is the call of the prophets and the messengers and those who followed them after them.
تكثير الحسنات.
Also, it increases our good deeds.
تكفير السيئات.
And it forgives and expiates our bad deeds.
استقرار الأمن والهداية والطمأنينة وحلاوة الإيمان.
Also, only through Tawheed is there safety, security, and does a person taste the sweetness of Iman.
سبب لشفاعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Also, Tawheed is a cause which will bring about the intercession of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
حتى لا نقع في الشرك.
And also, we should study Tawheed so we don't fall into shirk.
ثم لو يسألك سائل.
And then, if a person was going to ask you,
هل أنت موحد؟
Are you a muwahid, a person of Tawheed?
تقول نعم أنا موحد.
And you will say, of course, yes, I am a muwahid, a person of Tawheed.
طيب ما هو التوحيد؟
Okay, if you are asked, what is Tawheed?
فإذا عرف التوحيد بما جاء به النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام هذا معناه أنه موحد.
So if you are able to define التوحيد according to the way of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, then yes, you are a person of Tawheed.
وإذا قال أنا لا أدري ما هو التوحيد.
However, if a person says I don't know the meaning of Tawheed.
هذا معناه أنه كاذب في قوله أنه موحد.
Then this means that he is lying when it comes to him claiming that he is a person of Tawheed.
نعم. ثم لو قال لك قائل هل أنت مشرك؟
If a person said to you, are you a mushrik, a person of shirk? تقول أعوذ بالله أنا لست مشرك.
And you will say, I seek the refuge of Allah. I am not a person of shirk.
طب ما هو الشرك الذي حرم الله عليك؟
And then if you are asked, what is the shirk which Allah has forbidden upon you?
يقول ما لا أدري.
And a person says, I don't know.
طيب لعلك واقع في الشرك الأكبر وأنت لا تدري.
Perhaps you are falling into the major shirk and yet you don't know that you are falling into it.
رخصة القيادة، رخصة قيادة السيارة.
A driving license.
كيف تحصل عليها؟
How does a person acquire or obtain a driving license?
لابد أن تدرس.
You have to study.
تدرس ماذا؟
What do you study?
الأشياء التي لابد أن تأتي بها.
You have to study those things which you know have are going to come up.
والأشياء التي لابد أن تجتنبها.
So you need to study those things which you have to do and those things which you are not allowed to do.
بهذا تأخذ هذه الشهادة.
And this is the only way you can obtain a driving license.
كيف تكون مسلم؟ كيف تكون موحد؟
And similarly, how do you become a Muslim? How do you be a person of Tawheed?
لابد أن تعرف التوحيد وتعرف الشرك.
You have to know التوحيد and you have to know everything which opposes التوحيد أي الشرك.
وهذا أهم العلوم.
And this is the most important aspect of knowledge.
إذا لابد أن ندرس التوحيد.
Therefore, we have to study Tawheed.
فما هو التوحيد؟
So what is Tawheed?
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما يختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
So the meaning of التوحيد is to single out Allah in everything which is unique and specific to Him, whether it's in matters of ربوبية or ألوهية or أسماء والصفات.
هذا معناه أن التوحيد ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
So this means we're going to explain this that توحيد we can divide it into three categories.
إذا لابد من واحد من إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأنواع التوحيد الثلاثة.
So a person of توحيد, a موحد, he has to single out Allah in each one of these three aspects.
توحيد الربوبية ما هو؟
Firstly, توحيد الربوبية. What is it?
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله.
It is to single out Allah with regards to your belief in His actions.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
Meaning that you single out Allah as being the only creator and the one who controls and owns everything.
الثاني توحيد الألوهية أو توحيد العبودية أو توحيد العبادة.
And then the second category of التوحيد is called either توحيد الألوهية or it is called توحيد العبودية or sometimes it is called توحيد العبادة.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعال العباد.
And this is to single out Allah in every one of your actions, of our actions as worshippers.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة.
Or to single out Allah when it comes to our acts of worship, our ibadah.
لا يمكن أن تصرف شيء من العبادة لغير الله.
It's not possible for a person, it's not correct for a person to direct any act of worship to other than Allah.
الثالث توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
And then the third type or category of توحيد is the توحيد of the names and attributes or descriptions of Allah.
وهو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأسمائه وصفاته.
And this is to single out Allah in every unique description and name which He possesses.
وهو أي توحيد الأسماء والصفات هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى ووصف به نفسه في الكتاب والسنة.
So the meaning of توحيد الأسماء والصفات is that a person affirms and singles out Allah with every name and every description which Allah has affirmed for Himself. Either in the book or upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
فلا بد أن نثبت كل ما أثبت الله سبحانه وتعالى نفسه وأثبت له رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So we have to affirm everything which Allah has affirmed for Himself, either in the book or in the sunnah.
وكل وننفي كل ما نفى الله سبحانه وتعالى عن نفسه ونفى عنه رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And also we have to negate from Allah everything which He has negated from Himself in the Quran or in the sunnah.
نثبت ما أثبت الله سبحانه وتعالى نفسه وأثبت له رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So we affirm everything which Allah and His Messenger has affirmed for Allah.
وننزه الله سبحانه وتعالى عن مماثلة الخلق.
And at the same time, we free Allah from any comparison to creation.
ونعلم أن كل ما ورد في الكتاب والسنة فمعناه بين واضح.
And also, everything which is found in the Quran and the Sunnah, then its meaning is absolutely clear.
الكيفية علمها عند الله نؤمن أن لله كيفية تليق به سبحانه وتعالى لكن هذه الكيفية لا نعلمها والسؤال عنها بدعة.
As for the kayfiyya, either actual reality, then this is only encompassed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
نعم. إذن هذا هو التوحيد.
So this is the meaning of التوحيد.
بأنواع الثلاثة.
With its three categories.
نعم. ما هو الشرك؟
What is a shirk?
A shirk ينقسم إلى قسمين.
Shirk can be categorized into two main types.
Shirk أكبر وشرك أصغر.
Shirk أكبر, the major form of shirk, and shirk أصغر, the minor form of shirk.
إذا مات الإنسان نسأل الله عليه وسلم على الشرك الأكبر فهو خالد مخلد خلود أبدي في النار.
If a person dies upon a shirk al-akbar, we ask Allah for safety and pardoning, then he will reside forever in eternity in the hellfire.
وإذا مات نسأل الله عليه وسلم على الشرك الأصغر يعذب بقدر شركه ثم يدخل الجنة.
And if a person dies upon the minor form of shirk, we ask Allah for pardoning and safety, then he will be punished according to his level of shirk, and then he enters into Jannah.
على أي اعتبار؟ لابد أن نحذر من الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر.
In any case, we have to be aware and cautious of the types of shirk, whether it is major shirk or minor shirk.
فعندنا مراتب أربعة.
So therefore, we have four different levels.
صغائر.
We have the minor sins, the صغائر.
وأعلى منها كبائر.
And then more severe than the minor sins are the kabair, the major sins.
وأعلى من الكبائر الشرك الأصغر.
And then more severe than the major sins is minor shirk.
وأعلى شيء الشرك الأكبر صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the most severe of all of the sins is الشرك الأكبر, major shirk. We ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
فالصغائر تؤدي إلى الكبائر.
So a person committing minor sins will make him fall into committing major sins.
والكبائر تؤدي للشرك الأصغر.
And a person committing major sins will end up moving on to minor shirk.
والشرك الأصغر يؤدي للشرك الأكبر.
And a person falling into minor shirk will then end up falling into major shirk.
نعم. أيضا لو قال لك قائل هل أنت مسلم؟
Also, if a person said to you, "Are you a Muslim?"
تقول نعم.
You will say yes.
كيف أكون مسلم مثلك؟
And let's say this non-Muslim, he then asks you, how can I be a Muslim like you?
تقول لا أدري.
And you say, I don't know.
يقول إذا ما الفرق بيني وبينك؟
The non-Muslim will say, then what is the difference between me and between you?
قد يقول له تكون مسلم بقول أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد عبد رسول بالشهادتين.
Perhaps he will say to him that you become a Muslim by saying لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.
طيب هل هذه كلمة تقال فقط باللسان أو لابد من الاعتقاد ومعرفة معنى هذا الكلام؟
Okay, this statement لا إله إلا الله, is it something which is merely said and pronounced upon the tongue, or does a person have to have knowledge and belief and awareness regarding the meaning of لا إله إلا الله؟
يقول لابد تعرف معناه.
The person will say, of course, you have to know its meaning.
طيب هل تعرف أنت معناها؟
Okay, do you know the meaning of لا إله إلا الله؟
يقول لا.
And he says no.
يقول إذا ما الفرق بين هذا الكافر وبين هذا الذي يقول لا إله إلا الله ولا يعرف معناه؟
So therefore, what is the difference between the non-Muslim, the disbeliever, and the Muslim who says لا إله إلا الله but he doesn't know the meaning of لا إله إلا الله؟
ما هو الإسلام؟
What is Islam?
الإسلام هو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد, أن تسلم لله بأن تفرد الله بأنواع التوحيد الثلاثة.
So the definition or the meaning of Islam is الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد, meaning a person completely submits himself to Allah, he shows complete submission to Allah with التوحيد, i.e. with the three types of توحيد.
يعني هذا يقول لماذا نصلي الفجر ركعتين والظهر أربع ركعات.
So for example, a particular person, he says, why do we have to pray Fajr two rak'at and yet Dhuhr we pray four rak'at?
هل أنت مسلم؟
Are you a Muslim?
يقول نعم.
He says yes.
إذا تسلم لمن؟
Therefore, you have to show complete submission to Allah.
طيب لماذا نجهر في صلاة الفجر ولا نجهر بالقراءة في صلاة الظهر؟
Okay, why do we recite the Fajr prayer out aloud and yet the Dhuhr prayer we don't recite aloud?
هل أنت مسلم؟
Are you a Muslim?
نعم.
He says yes.
لابد تسلم لله.
You submit to the will of Allah.
ولا تشرع.
And you don't need to legislate.
ولا تعترض.
And neither do you need to oppose or question.
تقول سمعنا وأطعنا.
Rather you say we have heard and we obey.
إذن الإسلام هو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد.
So therefore, the definition of Islam is الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد. A person shows complete submission to Allah with توحيد.
والانقياد له بالطاعة. مسلم لابد أن يطيع الله سبحانه وتعالى ولا يعصي.
And also, the next meaning of Islam is والانقياد له بالطاعة. That a person complies to Allah through obedience.
هل أنت مسلم؟
Are you a Muslim?
نعم.
Yes.
لماذا لا تصلي؟
Why do you not pray?
هل أمرك الله بالصلاة؟
Did Allah order you to pray?
نعم.
Yes.
إذا لابد أن تطيع الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Therefore, you have to comply to the obedience of Allah.
الثالث يعني في التعريف القسم الثالث في التعريف البراءة من الشرك وأهله.
And then the third part of the meaning of Tawheed, we said that of Islam, we said Islam, it means الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد والانقياد له بالطاعة. Now the third section of this definition is
البراءة من الشرك وأهله.
Is البراءة من الشرك وأهله, for a person to completely free himself from shirk and also the people of shirk.
انقسم الناس تجاه التعامل مع الكفار إلى طرفين وسط.
When it comes to interacting with the people of disbelief, the kuffar, then people are categorized into three main types. Two extremes and one in the middle.
قسم يسب الكفار.
So there is an extreme who insults the disbelievers.
ويتعدى عليهم.
And oppresses or exceeds the limits with regards to the disbelievers.
بالقتل.
By killing them.
والضرب.
And violence and hitting them.
والسرقة.
And also stealing from them.
والخيانة.
Deception and treachery against them.
ولا يحفظ لهم أي حق من الحقوق التي أمرنا بأدائها لهم.
And this extreme do not protect those rights of the non-Muslims which we have been ordered to protect and safeguard.
القسم الثاني.
The second extreme.
يشارك الكفار.
Are those people who cooperate with the disbelievers
في أعيادهم
and take part in their celebrations and festivals
وفي احتفالاتهم
in their celebrations
وفي لباسهم
and dress how they dress
وترى تظنه منهم واحد منهم.
And if you would see this person, you would think that he's from the non-Muslims.
وقسم وسط. And then, على السنة والجماعة سأل الله يجعلنا وإياكم منهم.
And then there is a group who are in the middle between the both extremes. And they are the people of Sunnah. May Allah make me and you from them.
نحفظ لهؤلاء الحقوق التي أمرنا أمرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى بأدائها لهم.
And we, or those in the middle, they safeguard and protect the rights of the non-Muslims which Allah has ordered us to guarantee and safeguard.
نفي لهم بالعهود.
So we are truthful to our promises and our word with them.
لا نتعرض لهم لا بالسب ولا بالقتل ولا بأخذ الأموال ولا بالسرقة.
And there's no violence, there's no oppression. We don't take their wealth, we don't steal their wealth.
ولا نشاركهم في عيادهم ولا في احتفالاتهم ولا في طقوسهم ولا في لباسهم.
But at the same time, we don't partake in their celebrations, we don't partake in their festivals. We don't dress in a manner which resembles their dressing.
نحب والله لهم الخير وهو الإسلام ولذلك ندعوهم إلى الإسلام.
By Allah, we love goodness for them. We love goodness for the non-Muslims. But what is this goodness? It is al-Islam. It is al-Tawheed. And therefore we call them to Islam.
ونريد لكم الخير بالدخول في الإسلام.
So we say to them, we want goodness for you and that is by you entering into Islam.
ندعوهم للإسلام.
We call them to Islam.
دعاء بالقول ودعاء بالفعل.
And this dua, this calling that we make,
يعني دعوة الكفار تكون بالقول وبالفعل.
So this da'wah
This preaching to the non-Muslims towards Islam, it has to be done through our words and also with our actions.
Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان الكفار يقولون للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ويسمون النبي يقولون عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الصادق الأمين. إذا لابد أن نصدق ونكون أمناء.
The non-Muslims towards the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and how he used to deal with them, they used to call him الصادق الأمين, the truthful one and the one who is trustworthy. So again, in our dealings with the non-Muslims, we have to be truthful and we have to be trustworthy.
نتعامل معهم في البيع والشراء والإيجار.
Also, we deal with them, we interact with them, we have transactions with them, buying, selling, renting.
إذا لابد أن نعامل الكفار كما صنع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة رضي الله عنهم.
So we have to interact with the non-Muslims, with the disbelievers, how or in the manner in which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions used to interact with them.
ولابد أن نحذر ممن يتعرض لهؤلاء بالقتل وبالسب وأخذ الأموال.
And also we have to warn against those people who oppress them, transgress against them, insult them, and are violent towards them.
كذلك ونحذر من يختلط بهم حتى يكون واحد منهم في أعيادهم واحتفالاتهم وطقوسهم.
But at the same time, we have to warn against those people who are one with them in terms of partaking in their celebrations and festivals and the way of dressing and so on and so forth.
Now, إذا هذا هو الإسلام.
So therefore, this is Islam.
لابد أن يفرق بين المسلم والكافر.
There has to be a distinction between a Muslim and a non-Muslim.
كما هناك فرق بين اليهودي والنصراني.
Just as there is a difference and a distinction between a Jew and a Christian.
نعم. إذا ما هي مراتب الدين؟
Next, what are the different levels of the religion?
من يعرف مراتب الدين ما هي أو كم؟
Who knows how many levels there are of the religion? How many?
نعم. ثلاثة.
Three.
الإسلام.
First, الإسلام.
والإيمان.
And then إيمان.
والإحسان.
And then thirdly, الإحسان.
إذن مراتب الدين ثلاثة.
So the levels of our religion are three levels.
الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان.
Firstly, Islam. Secondly, إيمان. And thirdly, إحسان.
وكل مرتبة من هذه المراتب الثلاثة لها أركان.
And each one of these three levels has certain pillars.
فأركان الإسلام خمسة.
So the pillars of Islam are five.
الركن الأول من أركان الإسلام.
The first pillar from the pillars of Islam.
شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله.
Is a person bearing witness and testifying that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah alone.
تشهد.
That you have to bear witness.
أي تقول بلسانك وتعتقد بقلبك وتعمل بجوارحك.
Meaning you testify with your tongue. You believe with your heart, and also you have to then testify with your actions.
Allah ilaha, أي لا أحد يستحق أن يعبد إلا الله.
So لا إله إلا الله, it has two main parts. Firstly, لا إله, in which you are negating any deity, any god which is deserving of worship.
إذن لابد في لا إله إلا الله حتى يعني تكون تنفع قائلها لابد لها من ركنين, يعني بناء لا إله إلا الله كالبناء يقوم على عمودين.
So this phrase لا إله إلا الله, if you want it to be correct, if you want it to be beneficial to you, then it has to be like a building which is built upon two pillars.
لا إله نافيا جميع ما عبد من دون الله, تكفر بكل ما يعبد من دون الله, كل ما عبد من دون الله فعبادة باطلة.
So the first pillar of La ilaha illallah is the saying La ilaha, meaning you have to reject and disbelieve in every deity which is worshipped besides Allah.
إِلَّا اللَّهُ مُثْبِتًا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ.
And then the second pillar is the saying إِلَّا اللَّهُ, meaning you are affirming and establishing your worship of Allah alone.
يعني معناها لا معبود بحق إلا الله.
So therefore the meaning of لا إله إلا الله is لا معبود بحق إلا الله. There is no deity truly
worthy of worship except Allah.
يعني كل ما عبد من دون الله عبادة باطل والمستحق للعبادة هو الله.
Meaning, any deity which is worshipped besides Allah, then the worship it is falsehood. And the only worship which is accepted is the worship of Allah.
وأن محمدا عبده ورسول عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then secondly, we say, أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يعني عبد أي أنه عليه الصلاة والسلام ليس له شيء من خصائص الربوبية.
So we say that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's the عبد of Allah and he's the رسول of Allah. When it comes to عبد, meaning he himself is a worshipper and he does not have any rights to the rububiyyah of Allah, to the lordship of Allah. He has no attribute of lordship.
يعني ما يمكن أن يعبد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من دون الله.
Meaning that the Prophet himself can never be worshipped.
وكذلك معنى عبد أي أنه أعبد الخلق عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And also the other meaning of عبد is that he was the most worshipping of the people and creation towards Allah.
أكمل عبادة هي عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولا طريق لعبادة الله إلا بالتأسي بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The most complete and perfect worship of Allah was that which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did. Therefore, it isn't possible for a person to ever worship Allah except through emulating the worship of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ولا يمكن أن يقول إنسان أن معنى عبد أي أنه عليه الصلاة والسلام رقيق. ما يمكن يقال هذا أصلاً.
And therefore, it's not correct for a person to say that the meaning of عبد is that he is a slave.
ما يمكن. عبد أي أنه عليه الصلاة والسلام ليس له شيء من خصائص الربوبية وهو أعبد الخلق أكمل عبادة هي عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the word عبد الله, it doesn't mean that he is a slave. Rather, it means two things. Firstly, that he himself is a worshipper and he's not worshipped. And secondly, he did the most complete and perfect form of worship.
نعم. وهو عليه الصلاة والسلام اختصه الله سبحانه وتعالى بالرسالة.
And then the second description is Rasulullah, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified and he chose the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to convey his message.
فماذا نصنع؟
Therefore, what should we do?
نطيع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل ما أمر به.
We have to show obedience to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in every command.
ونصدق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل ما أخبر به.
And we have to believe in everything which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us.
فهو عليه الصلاة والسلام الصادق المصدوق.
Because he صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is the most truthful and the one who has been testified to being the most truthful.
و كل نجتنب كل ما نهى عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني نجعل ما نهى عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في جانب ونحن في جانب آخر.
And also the meaning of أشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is that we have to avoid and stay away from everything which he has forbidden. Meaning that whatever he has forbidden we put in a corner and we make sure that we are on the other corner.
وَأَلَّا يُعْبَدَ اللَّهُ إلا بما جاء عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني لا نبتدع في دين الله.
And also the other meaning of أشهد أن محمد رسول الله is that we do not worship Allah except in the way which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has legislated, i.e. we do not commit or innovate into the religion.
يعني من عبد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا لم يشهد شهادة أن محمد عبد رسول.
So the person who worships the Prophet, then he hasn't bore witness.
من كذلك ابتدع في دين الله.
And whoever innovates in the religion, brings bid'ah in the religion.
من كذب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And whoever does not accept what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said.
أو قال أنه ليس برسول.
Or a person who says that he isn't a messenger.
أو ترك ما أمر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو ما نهى عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Or if a person abandons and avoids that which the Prophet ordered for us to do, or a person does that which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade us from doing.
نعم. الركن الثاني من أركان الإسلام. نعم ما هو الركن الثاني أو كان
What الإسلام? is the second pillar of Islam? The second pillar of Islam.
نعم.
What is the second pillar of Islam?
قد الشهادة first.
نعم الثاني.
الصلاة.
نعم. هل قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الركن الثاني الصلاة؟
نعم.
هل قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الركن الثاني أركان الإسلام قال الصلاة؟
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he spoke by the pillars of the prayer, when he said the second pillar, did he say the second pillar is as-salah, merely as-salah?
هل قال الصلاة فقط؟
So did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say just the salah, just prayer?
ما أحد يتكلم إلا باستئذان.
Nobody should speak without permission.
إلا هناك في السوق، في أماكن اللعب، عند الكرة، الكل هنا ما أحد يتكلم. الجن لم يتكلم في مجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Except out there in the marketplaces, all playing football. But when it comes to the gatherings of knowledge. Then even the jinn, they will not speak without the permission of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
إذا ما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الركن الثاني الصلاة.
So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he never said that the second pillar it is as-salah, it is the prayer.
لماذا?
Why not?
لماذا قال إقام الصلاة?
Rather he said إقام الصلاة, establishing the prayer. Why did he say إقامة?
إقام الصلاة حتى تأتي بها قائمة.
So the meaning of establishing the prayer or iqam al-salah is that you bring the prayer in its most upright and correct sense.
تام.
Complete and perfect.
بشروطها.
Fulfilling its conditions.
وأركانها.
And its pillars.
وواجباتها.
And its obligations.
وسننها.
And even the recommended acts.
ومكملاتها.
And everything which perfects the prayer.
ولا تأتي بمبطل.
And you do not bring any invalidator, anything which falsifies or invalidates the prayer.
لأن ممكن هذا يأتينا هذا الأخ.
Because perhaps this brother he will come to us.
يقول أنا أصلي في اليوم في آخر الليل ركعتين.
And he says that I am going to pray at the end of the day two ركعات.
فأنا أتيت بالركن الثاني من أركان الإسلام.
So I have now fulfilled the second pillar of Islam.
وهذا يصلي دون يقرأ الفاتحة.
And another person he prays but without reciting Surah Fatiha.
وهذا يصلي بدون وضوء.
And another one prays without wudu.
ويقول الحمد لله هذا الذي أصنع وأسأل الله يتقبل.
And all of them say that this is my prayer and Allah will accept it from me.
لا. الركن إقام الصلاة تأتي بها قائمة كما أمر الله.
No. Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he didn't merely say pray. He said إقام الصلاة. The establishing of the prayer in its most upright and correct and perfect sense.
لأن بعض الناس يقول أنا أحسن من غيري، غيري لا يصلي وأنا أصلي ركعتين والحمد لله.
Because some people they say that at least I am better than the one who doesn't pray anything. At least I'm praying two ركعات in the day as opposed to the person who does not pray anything.
ويصلي أحيانا البعض خاصة في البطال وعندما يسجد ويركع تنكشف من خلفه العورة السوءة وتنبه بعض الصلاة قال يا أخي أنت متشدد.
And perhaps another person, especially those brothers who pray in trousers, they pray and the trousers are so tight that when a person goes into sujood or goes down and bows down, that some of his awrah it is showing. And then if a person was to come to this brother and advise him that look, your awrah is showing, he say you're متشدد, you're extreme, you're harsh.
إذا أردت أن تنصح انصح من لا يصلي أنا أصلي الحمد لله.
And the person says, if you want to advise, why don't you go advise the one who isn't praying? At least I'm praying.
طيب أنت بهذا صلاتك باطلة.
But you, the one who is praying like this, then your prayer is false, not accepted.
أنت ومن لا يصلي سواء.
So you and the one who isn't praying are absolutely equal.
لماذا تتعب نفسك وتضيع أجر الصلاة على أمر يسير جدا وهو ستر العورة.
So why are you wasting your prayer? Why are you wasting your actions and wasting the reward over a thing which is so small, i.e. covering your awrah, covering your private body parts?
الركن الثالث.
The third pillar of Islam is
ما هو?
What is it?
نعم.
إيتاء الزكاة.
لم يقل الزكاة.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't say al-zakat.
قال إيتاء الزكاة.
He said إيتاء الزكاة.
يعني لابد أن تؤخذ من المآخذ الشرعية.
Meaning that this zakah, it has to be taken from the legislated ways.
وتصرف إلى أهل الزكاة.
And it has to be given to those people who are deserving of zakah.
مقدار معين.
And it has to be given according to the measures which have been detailed.
لطائفة معينة.
For each group that has been mentioned.
في زمن مخصوص.
And it has been, it has to be given in its correct time.
لأن هذا قد يكون لديه أموال كثيرة.
Because perhaps a brother, he has a lot of wealth.
ويجب عليه مثلا إخراج مليون دولار مثلا.
And the obligation upon this person is that, for example, he has to give £1,000,000.
وهو يخرج يقول 10 دولارات.
But he only gives $10, for example.
لماذا؟
Why?
قال الحمد لله أحسن من غير.
He says, at least I'm better than the one who's giving nothing.
هل هذا قام بالركن الثالث؟
Has this person fulfilled the third pillar of Islam?
لا. نعم. الركن الرابع.
The fourth pillar of Islam is
صيام رمضان. نعم.
Is the fasting of the month of Ramadan.
طيب والخامس.
And the fifth pillar,
حج بيت الله الحرام لمن استطاع عليه سبيلا,
is to perform the Hajj, to perform the pilgrimage to the house of Allah for the one who has an ability to do so.
أسأل الله يبلغني إياكم الحج.
I ask Allah that He allows me and you to make Hajj.
نعم. المرتبة الثانية.
Now the second level of the religion,
الإيمان,
is الإيمان.
لو قال لك قائل هل أنت مؤمن؟
If a person said to you, are you a مؤمن؟
تقول نعم.
And you say yes.
ما هو الإيمان؟
What is إيمان؟
تقول لا أدري.
And you say I don't know.
هل أنت من أهل السنة والجماعة؟
Are you therefore from أهل السنة والجماعة؟
لا تقتر بنفسك وتقول نعم. وإذا لم أكن أنا لا أدري من يكون في هذه الأيام من أهل السنة والجماعة غيري.
So if you are asked, are you from أهل السنة؟ Don't deceive yourself or don't be haughty and proud. That yes, I am from أهل السنة. And if I am not from أهل السنة, then who is it? Who else is from أهل السنة؟
نعم. تقول أسأل الله أن يجعلني منهم يا رب.
Rather say I ask Allah that He makes us from أهل السنة.
نعم. ما هو الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة؟
So what is إيمان according to أهل السنة والجماعة؟
قول باللسان.
It is a statement upon the tongue.
واعتقاد بالقلب.
And a belief in the heart.
وعمل القلب.
And an action of the heart.
وعمل الجوارح.
And also actions of the limbs.
يزيد بالطاعة.
And through obedience to Allah, Iman keeps increasing.
وينقص بالمعصية.
And through disobedience to Allah, Iman keeps decreasing.
قول باللسان.
So Iman, it is a statement upon the tongue.
واعتقاد بالقلب.
It is a belief of the heart.
وعمل القلب والجوارح.
And it is the action of the heart and the actions upon the limbs.
يزيد بالطاعة.
It increases in obedience to Allah.
وينقص بالمعصية.
And it decreases in disobedience to Allah.
إذا لابد في تعريف الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة لابد في التعريف من أمور خمسة.
So therefore, the definition of Iman according to the people of Sunnah has to complete or fulfill five matters.
أما أركان الإسلام أركان الإيمان فهي ستة.
But the pillars of Iman are six. This was the definition of Iman. The pillars of Iman, there are six pillars.
نعم. قول باللسان.
So again, the definition of Iman is a person, the statement upon the tongue.
واعتقاد بالقلب.
And the belief of the heart.
وعمل القلب والجوارح.
And the actions of the heart and the limbs.
يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية.
It increases with obedience and decreases with disobedience.
عندي سؤال.
I have a question.
أو أكثر.
Or more than a question.
إنسان يقول بلسانه كل ما جاء به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لكن لا يعتقد بقلبه.
A person, he says everything which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered to be said. However, he does not have the belief in the heart.
هل هذا مؤمن أو مسلم أو كافر أو ضعيف الإيمان أو ماذا؟
Is this person a مؤمن or is he a Muslim or is he a disbeliever, كافر or is he somebody who's just weak in his إيمان?
يقول بلسانه كل ما قال به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لكن لا يعتقد بقلبه.
So he says with his tongue everything which the Prophet said, but he does not believe with his heart.
نعم. ليس بمؤمن. نعم.
He is not a mu'min.
نعم.
ممكن هو من المنافقين.
ممكن من المنافقين.
Perhaps he is from the people of hypocrisy, nifaq.
نعم.
منافقين.
من المنافقين.
منافق.
في نفاق.
He has hypocrisy in him.
طيب نفاق هل هذا أكبر أو أصغر؟
Okay, this nifaq, this hypocrisy, is it a major hypocrisy or the minor hypocrisy?
ما أحد يتكلم إلا برفع الأصبع.
Raise your
finger. نعم.
النفاق الأكبر.
نفاق أكبر مخلد خلود أبدي في النار.
The hypocrisy or the nifaq of this person is the major form of nifaq which necessitates that he remains and abides in eternity in Jahannam, in the fire.
السؤال الثاني.
Second question.
عندنا من إنسان يعتقد كل ما جاء به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعتقد شهادة لا إله إلا الله ونبي من عبد الرسول والصلاة والإيمان وكان كل شيء. لكن لا يقول بلسانه وهو قادر على الكلام.
We have another person who believes in everything which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered. He believes in the shahadatain, he believes in tawheed, he believes in the prayer, he believes in everything. But he does not pronounce, he does not testify upon his tongue, even though he's able to do so.
نعم. إذن يعتقد كل شيء جاء به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لكن لا يقول بلسانه وقادر على الكلام.
So this person, he believes everything in his heart, but he does not say it upon his tongue.
ما هذا؟
So what's the ruling of this person?
نعم.
هو كافر.
كافر. نعم.
Muslim depending on the situation. You don't know.
حسب الظرف يعني ضروراً ما نعرف لماذا لا يتكلم.
هو يتكلم صحيح ليس فيه إشكال.
He can speak. He has the ability to speak, but he doesn't.
ليس لديه أي مرض ولا إشكال.
There's no illness. There's no necessity.
كافر.
كافر.
فيه نفاق وإيدم
فيه إيمان وفيه نفاق.
فيه نفاق وفيه وهم.
نعم. المهم ضعيف الإيمان.
So he has إيمان but he also has a level of hypocrisy in him.
نعم.
He's not a true believer.
ليس بالمؤمن حقا.
ليس بالمؤمن حقا. نعم. غيره.
Anybody else?
أئمة الكفر على هذا.
The imams of kufr, the leaders of kufr, they are upon this.
Iblis على هذا.
Iblis, he was like this.
Iblis يعتقد كل شيء.
Iblis used to believe everything.
لكن لا يقول بلسان.
But he does not say upon his tongue.
فرعون على هذا يعتقد بقلبه.
فرعون was also upon this level.
أبو جهل على هذا.
أبو جهل also.
أئمة الكفر على هذا.
So the most severe of the kuffar, the disbelievers, they were upon this.
وجحدوا بها واستيقنتها أنفسهم.
Like Allah said in the Quran, that despite them believing in this with certainty, with yaqeen, but they stubbornly refused to say it.
يعني اعتقد بقلبه ولم يقل بلسانه. معنى الآية.
The meaning of the ayah is they should believe it in their heart, but they refused to say it.
قلنا لكم الإيمان قول وعمل واعتقاد يزيد وينقص.
Because we said to you that iman, it is a statement, it is a belief, it is an action, it increases and it decreases.
إذا معنى هذا أننا لا نصلح للفتوى.
So the meaning of this is that we're not correct to give fatwa.
صحيح. نعم. فما بالك من اليوم يطلق الأحكام على الأشخاص يقول فلان كافر، فلان منافق، فلان مبتدع، فلان مرجع، فلان ضال مضل، فلان كذا.
So what do you think about those people who are always making rulings on other people? That this person, he is a kafir, and this person, he is misguided, and this one, he is an innovator, and this one, he is a murji, and this one, he is the most misguided of people.
Now, arkan al-iman kam.
So, how many pillars do we have of iman? How many are the pillars of iman?
Arkan al-iman. Now,
sitta.
Now,
6. الأول أن تؤمن بالله. The first pillar is that you have إيمان in Allah.
هل أنت مؤمن بالله؟
Are you a mu'min in Allah?
تقول نعم.
You say yes.
طيب اشرح لي كيف أصل إلى هذا الركن؟ كيف أحقق هذا الركن الإيمان بالله؟
And then if a person comes to this person and he says, okay, explain to me how I can also achieve this pillar of إيمان.
تقول والله لا أدري.
And you say, by Allah, I don't know.
إذا معنى هذا أن هذا القائل غير مؤمن بالله أصلا.
So the meaning of this is that a person who said he is the believer in Allah, in reality he isn't a believer.
الإيمان بالله يتضمن الإيمان بتوحيد الربوبية.
So if a person wants to have إيمان in Allah, then it has to include إيمان in his ربوبية
والألوهية.
And his uluhiyah, his right of worship.
والأسماء والصفات.
And his names, attributes, and descriptions.
وتؤمن بوجود الله سبحانه وتعالى.
So you have to have firm belief and iman in the existence of Allah.
ودل على وجود الله أدلة إجمالية أربعة.
And as for the existence or the wujud of Allah, then there are four main evidences that prove this.
العقل.
Firstly, our own intellect and logic.
لأنه لا يمكن أن يأتي عاقل وينظر في هذا الكون وفي هذه المخلوقات إلا ولا بد أن يثبت أن لهذا الخلق خالق واحد مدبر سبحانه وتعالى.
Because it isn't possible for an intelligent person to come and he sees all of this creation and yet he doesn't believe that this creation has a creator.
الثاني من الأدلة على وجود الله الحس. يعني ما يدرك بالحواس.
The second evidence or proof for the existence of Allah is that which we can sense.
الآن أنت تكون في كرب شدة ترفع يديك للسماء تقول يا رب فرجها تجدها تنفرج هذا دليل محسوس.
So look how for example when you are in a time of difficulty you raise your hands to Allah you say oh Allah remove me from these difficulties and Allah removes you from
them. قام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يدعو فنزل الغيث.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started supplicating for the rain prayer until the rain came down.
الثالث الفطرة كل مولود يولد على الفطرة.
And the third proof for the existence of Allah is the fitrah. The natural innate belief that Allah has made in every single human being in the existence of a creator.
فهذا دليل على وجود الله.
So this is an evidence for the existence of Allah.
الشرع الكتاب والسنة.
And then fourthly is the Sharia, the legislation.
إذن الأدلة إجمالاً على وجود الله أربعة.
The book and the Sunnah. So therefore, the four evidences which prove the existence of Allah are four.
العقل.
A person's logic and intellect.
الحس.
And what a person senses.
الفطرة.
A person's natural disposition.
الشرع.
And the Sharia.
إذن كيف نحقق الإيمان بالله ركن الأول؟
So how do we actualize and realize our iman in Allah, which is the first pillar of iman?
تؤمن بتوحيد الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات وتؤمن بوجود الله.
You have to believe in four aspects. Firstly, you have to believe in the wujud of Allah, the existence of Allah, and also in the ربوبية, the lordship of Allah, and ألوهية, the sole right of Allah to your worship, and the أسماء والصفات, the names, descriptions, attributes, qualities of Allah.
وتؤمن بوجود الله.
And also, as I mentioned, the existence of Allah.
نعم. الثاني من أركان الإيمان.
The second pillar of iman.
نعم. الإيمان بالملائكة.
Is having iman in the malaika, in the angels.
تؤمن بأنهم أن الملائكة خلقهم الله سبحانه وتعالى.
So with regards to the angels, we believe that Allah has created them.
وهم عالم غيب لا نراهم.
And they are from the beings of the unseen. We don't see them.
خلقهم الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And Allah created them.
ولا يعصون الله ما أمرهم.
Allah created them and He commanded them and they do not go against His commandments.
نؤمن بهم وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى.
So we have to believe regarding them everything which Allah has taught us about them.
نعم وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من أسمائه.
So we have to believe the names which Allah has taught us regarding the angels.
جبريل.
Like جبريل.
وميكائيل.
ميكائيل.
وإسرافيل.
إسرافيل.
ملك الموت.
And ملك الموت, the angel of death.
نعم. وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من أعماله.
Also we have to believe their actions which Allah has taught us.
جبريل عليه السلام موكل بالوحي.
So for example, the responsibility or the action of جبريل عليه السلام is that he is responsible and entrusted with the revelation.
وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من صفاته.
Also, we have to believe in all of the descriptions which Allah has taught us about the angels.
لهم أجنحة.
We have to believe that they have wings.
لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم.
And the fact that they do not disobey Allah in His commandments.
ونؤمن بكل ما أخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى عنه.
So we believe in everything which Allah has taught us about the angels.
الركن الثالث.
The third pillar of Iman.
الإيمان بالكتب.
Is having Iman in the kutub, in the books of Allah.
نؤمن بأنها كلام الله.
So we have to believe that these divine books, they are the speech of Allah.
تكلم الله سبحانه وتعالى بها.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى spoke with these books, with what's in the books.
وأنزل على كل رسول كتاب.
And that He has revealed to every single messenger a book or a scripture.
ونؤمن بها بكل الكتب.
We have to believe in every single scripture.
وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من أسمائه.
And we have to believe in all of the names of those books which Allah has told us about.
القرآن.
The Quran.
والتوراة.
توراة.
والإنجيل.
إنجيل.
والزبور.
زبور.
وصحف إبراهيم. وموسى عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
And also the Suhuf or the scrolls of Ibrahim and Musa عليهم السلام.
وبما أعلمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من أخبارها.
Also,
الكتب.
Also, we have to believe in the information which came down in these scriptures and books.
والأحكام الواردة فيها ما لم تنسخ.
And also, we have to accept the rulings in these divine scriptures as long as they have not been abrogated by the Quran.
وأن القرآن ناسخ لهذه الكتب.
And we have to believe that the Quran came to abrogate the other books.
ولا يمكن أن نقرأ فيها.
And that we don't read those books.
لورود النهي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade us from reading those scriptures.
لأنه ماذا يريد بالقراءة فيها؟
Because what does the person want by reading those scriptures?
القرآن هذا فيه كل شيء.
The Quran, it contains everything.
ولأن دخلها التحريف.
And also because those scriptures were changed and altered.
وهذا القرآن أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالرجوع إليه.
And the Quran, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us to return back to the Quran.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا.
The next pillar.
الركن الرابع الإيمان بالأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
Is having iman or having belief in the prophets and the messengers of Allah.
أنهم ليس لهم شيء من خصائص الربوبية بشر.
So firstly, we have to believe that the prophets and messengers, they are humans. They have no characteristic of lordship.
نؤمن بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى أرسلهم.
So we have to believe that Allah, He's the one who has sent them.
وأوحى إليهم.
And He has revealed to them.
وأيدهم بالآيات.
And that He aided and supported them with many signs.
وأنهم والله أدوا الأمان.
And that those prophets and messengers by Allah, they fulfilled the responsibility and the trust.
ونصحوا الأمة.
And they sincerely advised the ummah.
وبلغوا كل ما أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى بتبليغه.
And they conveyed everything which Allah ordered them to convey.
وجاهدوا في الله حق جهاده بل جاهدوا بكل أنواع الجهاد التي أمرهم الله سبحانه وتعالى بها.
And that they strived in the way of Allah with the utmost striving. Rather, they fulfilled every different type of jihad.
وأن أول الأنبياء آدم. And
the first of the prophets is Adam, may peace be upon him.
وأول الرسل نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And the first of the messengers, the Rusul, is Nuh, may peace be upon him.
وخاتم الأنبياء والرسل محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And the seal or the final of all of the prophets and the messengers is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كل من ادعى النبوة أو الرسالة بعد موته عليه الصلاة والسلام فهو والله كاذب وكافر. كفر أكبر.
So anybody who comes and claims prophethood after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he is a disbeliever and he is a liar.
نؤمن بهم.
We have to believe in the prophets and messengers.
وبما علمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى من أسمائه.
And we have to believe in the names which Allah has told us.
وصفاته.
And the descriptions which Allah told us.
والآيات التي أعدهم الله سبحانه وتعالى بها.
We have to believe in the signs and the miracles that Allah has given them.
والأخبار التي جاءت عنهم.
And the information which they convey to us.
بعد هذا. الركن الخامس,
the fifth pillar,
الإيمان باليوم الآخر,
is a person having إيمان in the final day.
الأيام خمسة,
the days of five, there are five types of days.
يوم في العدم قبل أن تخلق.
So the first type of day is a day of non-existence.
ويوم
before you were created.
ويوم في الأجنة في بطن الأم.
And then a day meaning a phase when you are in the womb of your mother.
وَيَوْمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا.
And then the phase or the days of the dunya, of your worldly life.
وَيَوْمْ فِي الْقَبْرِ.
And then your days in the grave.
وَيَوْمْ الْآخِرِ. وَآخِرِ الْأَيَّامِ الْخَمْسَةِ.
And then
التي تمر بها. نعم. المراحل يعني.
And then the eternal day. When we say day, we mean the phases that you go through.
نعم. فالإيمان باليوم الآخر كيف يكون؟
So therefore, how does a person have the correct iman or the correct belief in the final day?
تؤمن بكل ما أخبر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مما يكون بعد الموت.
You have to believe in everything which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, which will occur after death.
خروج الروح.
So we have to believe in the exiting of the ruh.
قبض الملائكة لها.
And how the angels come to seize the soul.
صعود الملائكة بالروح إلى السماء.
And how the angels will come and they will take and ascend with their soul.
عودتهم بهذا الجسد.
And how the angels or the soul it returned back to the body.
سؤال الملكين في القبر عن الأصول الثلاثة.
And the fact that the two angels they will come into the grave and they will question us about the three questions.
من ربك ومن دينك ومن نبيك عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Who is your Lord? What is your religion? And who is your Prophet? May peace and blessings be upon him.
نعيم القبر.
A person has to believe in the delights and the reward of the grave.
عذاب القبر نسمع عنه السلام.
And the punishment of the grave, may Allah save us.
البعث بعد الموت.
And a person has to believe in the resurrection after death.
الجنة والنار.
A person has to believe in paradise and the fire.
كل ما يكون بعد الموت هو من الإيمان باليوم الآخر.
So everything which will occur after death, all of this comes under الإيمان باليوم الآخر.
الركن السادس.
The final sixth pillar of iman.
الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر.
Is a person having iman in القضاء and القدر.
كيف تحقق الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر؟
Meaning iman in the decree of Allah. How does a person truly actualize and have the correct iman when it comes to the decree of Allah?
تحقيق الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر يكون بأمور أربعة.
A person has to believe in four matters.
الأول أن تؤمن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى عالم كل شيء ولا يخفى عليه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء.
Firstly is the knowledge of Allah. You have to believe that Allah knows everything in the dunya. Nothing is hidden from the knowledge of Allah.
وأن الله سبحانه وتعالى أمر القلب أن يكتب مقادير كل شيء. كل شيء هو مكتوب عند الله سبحانه.
And then the second thing you have to believe is that Allah سبحانه وتعالى He ordered the pen to write everything which will occur. So anything which occurs has already been written.
الثالث أنه لا يمكن أن يقع في ملك الله إلا ما أراد الله.
And then the third aspect of iman in the qadr is that only those things which Allah wills to happen, happen. So nothing can happen in this universe without the will of Allah.
نعم. العبد له إرادة وله مشيئة لكن تحت مشيئة الله فما شاء الله كان وما لم يشاء لم يكن.
So yes, us as human beings, we also have a will. We also have the ability to make a decision. However, all of this is under the will of Allah. Whatever Allah wills occurs. Whatever Allah does not will never occur.
الرابع العبد مخلوق وأعماله تابعة له فهي مخلوقة مثله.
And then the fourth aspect of iman bil qadr is the actual creation of the will of Allah, meaning that we as people we have been created by Allah and our actions have also been created.
العلم أن تؤمن أن الله علم كل شيء.
So again, the four aspects of iman bil qadr is firstly knowledge. You believe that
that Allah has comprehensive knowledge and complete knowledge of everything.
وكتب كل ما يفعل العباد.
And the second level is the writing that Allah has written, or the pen has written everything which will occur.
وإثبات أن ما شاء الله كان وما لم يشاء لم يكن.
And then the third aspect is believing in the will of Allah. Whatever Allah wills occurs. Whatever He does not will never occur.
نعم. والعبد مخلوق وأعمال مخلوقة مثله.
And then finally, we believe that we are created, and the our actions are also created like us.
نعم. بعد هذا المرتبة الثالثة من مراتب الدين.
So finally, the third level of the religion,
الإحسان,
is الإحسان.
وهو ركن واحد.
And الإحسان is one pillar.
لكن تحت هذا الركن لابد من مرتبتين.
But this pillar, it has two different levels.
أعلى مرتبة,
the highest level of إحسان,
هي مرتبة المشاهدة, مرتبة العبادة التي تكون عن رغبة وحب وشوق فيما عند الله, وهذه هي عبادة الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
So the highest level of إحسان is for a person to worship Allah out of your love, your desire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And
يعني
this is
يعني أقوى دافع يدفع الإنسان للعبادة هو الرغبة والحب والشوق فيما عند الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And this is the worship of the prophets and the messengers, meaning that thing which moves you to worship Allah is you loving and wanting and desiring what Allah has, i.e. the reward which Allah has.
وهذا لا يعني أنه ليس لديه خوف. لا يمكن. لابد أن يجمع بين الخوف والرجاء.
And this doesn't mean that a person doesn't fear Allah. No. A person has to combine between fearing Allah and hoping in the reward of Allah.
فإن لم يستطع الوصول إلى هذه المرتبة لا يمكن أن يخرج عن المرتبة الثانية. فإن لم تكن ترى فإنه يراك عبادة خوف وهرب وتسمى عبادة المراقبة.
And if a person isn't able to worship Allah desiring his reward, then the second level, which is a lower level, and this is that you worship Allah out of fear. I.e., if you cannot worship Allah as though you see Him, then know that He sees you. And this is the worship which is built upon the fear of Allah.
ما هو الدليل على الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان؟
What is the evidence for these three levels of the religion, Islam and Iman and Ihsan?
حديث جبريل عليه السلام.
The famous hadith of جبريل عليه السلام.
نعم. الله أعلم نكتفي بهذا المقدار وهذا إن شاء الله تعالى. نعم.
I will suffice with this amount for today, but tomorrow
نبدأ بإذن الله تعالى بعد صلاة الظهر.
We will begin after Dhuhr. After Dhuhr prayer, we will begin the next lesson.
نراجع ما أخذنا.
So, revise everything which we have studied.
ثم نسأل عن الركن الثاني من أركان الإيمان. ثم نسأل عن الركن الثاني من أركان الإسلام.
And then we are going to ask about, or we're going to study the second pillar of Al-Islam, either prayer.
ما هي شروط الصلاة?
For example, what are the conditions of the prayer?
لا, سنسأل إن شاء الله عن شروط الصلاة.
We're going to question about the conditions of the prayer.
وأركان الصلاة.
And what are the pillars of the prayer.
واجبات الصلاة.
And obligations of the prayer.
وسنن الصلاة.
The recommended acts of the prayer.
ومبتغات الصلاة.
And those things which break a person's prayer.
ولو تكتب في ورقة وتسلم للإدارة حتى يعني نتعود على حفظ هذه الأمور. نعم.
الآن
يكتب الآن وغدا. المهم غدا قبل الدرس يسلم هذه الورقة.
So basically, the Shaykh wants you to sit together, revise together, look through the book, and look through what we're going to cover tomorrow, and try to make notes from the book, from page 53, about the pillars of the prayer and the conditions of the prayer. Summarize them and give it to Shaykh Omar.
نعم. إذا غدا إن شاء الله تعالى نسألكم عن إقام الصلاة الركن الثاني من أركان الإسلام.
So tomorrow we'll question you about these things which are present in the book. Everything is in the book.
أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولكم التوفيق والسداد. والله أعلم. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.